Hello friends, my name is Jitender Bapna. Today we will going to see how to implement CI/CD pipeline for your MuleSoft application. So in last two tutorials we have already seen how to check out the code from the GitHub, that is automatically check out. As soon as you check in the code, the Jenkins pipeline will pick the code, it will perform the build and it will deploy to the CloudHub. So we have already seen this in our past videos. Okay, in this video we will going to see how to perform the test, a Postman test, or how to run a Postman test collection on the after deploying application to CloudHub. So we will going to use a Newman utility. So for that, the first step is like you need to install Node.js. So you go to this site nodejs.org/en/download and install, you know, like whatever version you want to install. So for me, I have installed the Windows installer 64-bit. I have already installed it. It's very simple installation. It will download the MSI. Just click next. That's it. You don't have to do other thing. Now, apart from Node.js, we need to install or we need to download npm utility. So go to command prompt, run as an administrator, say npm install -g and say Newman. So I want to install npm Newman plugin. Enter. Let's wait. So it's downloading a Newman. Okay, it's completed a download of Newman. Where you can find the Newman? So go to C drive, then go to users, then go to Jitendra, then go to app data, roaming, then npm and node model. So Newman is here. Okay, now the next step, we have to run the Newman Postman collection. So for that we need to create a collection. So I have already deployed application in the CloudHub in last videos. So let me enter, it's taking some time today. Okay, so you can see the response back from a CloudHub. Let me put one enter. I will copy this URL. I will start creating the Postman collection, new collection. I will say world time zone. This is my collection name. I will say create. I will add request. I have already shown how to create a Postman collection in one of my video. And I will say get world time zone. That's it. Save to world time zone. Go to request, paste the URL and hit the send button. So we got a successful response. I will save this. Then I will put some test cases. So basically what are the test cases? I will say status code 200. Then I'll put one of the test cases related to response time. Then send. One of the test cases is filled because we have put the response time 200, but we received the response in 1338 milliseconds. So I will increase to 2000 milliseconds. I will change the text here 2000. I will save the application, then send. This time both are successful because we received the response within the 452 milliseconds. Let me export the Postman collection to one of my folder and save it. Now let me run, or let me do one thing. Go to app drive, Newman. Let me write the command here, Newman app, or just copy this file name and I will paste it here, and I will copy this command Newman run and this drive and the file location. I will paste it here. So it will generate a report, a command line report. So you can see it has generated a report, request one, success. So nothing is failed. It performed two test cases, everything was passed. Right? Now you want to generate the report in the form HTML. So for that, first you have to install this Newman reporter HTML extra. Copy this, paste it here, enter. So it will install Newman reporter HTML extra. Okay, it's done. Now you can see, now go to C drive, users, Jitendra, go to app data, roaming, npm, under node modules you will see Newman reporter HTML extra. So now I want to generate, run the report in, I want to generate a report in HTML format. So you use this command. Apart from that, say minus r HTML extra. So we are saying generate the report in HTML extra and export the report at this location. So I will copy this much of the command. So reporter hyphen HTML extra hyphen export. So I will export the report in this folder. Let me go to that folder. So let me check if there is any report exist or not. So currently there is no report or only JSON file. So I will go to command prompt. I will quickly run this. So let me go there. So it has generated the HTML report. You can see it here. Open the HTML report. So you can see total iteration 1, 2 assertion, both are successful. Nothing has been filled. So go to total request, open this, and you will see response code is 200, you know, 1095 millisecond response time. Even you can see the messages, and you can see the test cases has, which are the test cases has been run. They both are successful. Fine. So now what? If you want to generate a report in dark HTML, so you can use this tag hyphen hyphen reporter hyphen HTML extra hyphen dark theme. So it will generate the black report in the dark color. Paste it, enter. Okay, so it has generated a report. So which one is latest? 916 one is latest. It will be same report, but the theme has been changed. Fine. So now what I will do, I will go to Jenkins. So I will create one job. I will go to new item. I will quickly create world, time zone, test Newman collection, freestyle project. Okay. I have to copy that path. You go to that users, Jitendra, and go to app data, roaming, and npm. Go till this path and copy this path and go to build, add build step, execute Windows batch command, control V, and you give CD in front of this space, not too many space, only one space. Now what we can do, we will not going to run complete command, we will going to run this much of the command. Okay, Newman run, and we are not generating HTML report. And now say build now. Let me go to console. It is successful. Console output. So here you can see the report is in some junk character. How can you avoid this? So go to job again, configure it, and you need to add one tag in command. Say disable, let me, I always do the mistake in disable spelling, disable Unicode, save it, build now. Go to report now. So this time you can see the proper report. Now what I will do, I will run the hold command. Control C, I will go to world time zone, configure. Save it. Okay. So now we will not going to run again and again. So now we will do one thing. Instead, like I will go to pipeline. So in pipeline, checkout, build, and like deploy. And what we have done, the see the Postman collection automatically come here, because what we have to do during the deploy, I already added in my previous, so it was there previously. So configure, you simply have to go to post, add post build action. In that you say build other project and the give the name of your job. Okay, so that is the thing we have to do. So basically first checkout, build, deploy, and after deploy, in deploy we have to say after deploy build run this Postman test collection, save. Let me go to Jenkins, let me go to pipeline. I want this to get executed automatically. So for that I will remove some space from here. So it means I have done some changes. Save it, go to command prompt, say git status. So there is some modification happen. It can show pom.xml has been changed. Git add dot git commit minus m pom changes, enter. Now I will push code to the GitHub. Git push origin master. So it will push the code to the GitHub. So it already pushed the code to GitHub. Let me check in GitHub. So you can see it's 19 seconds ago. So I want to check whether my pipeline has been triggered or not. So generally it take like 1 to 2 minutes for pipeline to get triggered. Currently it's showing 9:04. So I will be waiting for at least 1 minute till 9:21. Okay, it has start checking out the code. It is green. Now it will build the code. Let me remove all the HTML report from that Newman folder. So we are sure that new report has been generated from Jenkins. So build is also successful. Let me check AnyPoint Studio, is anything is happening there. So it start deploying the application. Hopefully this time it will deploy. Something is gone wrong again. Let me check what happening to this. It is getting timeout. Something is problem with connection. We will run it once again. Let me enter it. Save all. Just 1 minute. So let me run once again. So I will git status, let me git commit. Okay, first we need to git add, git commit, git push origin master. So I think it will run the pipeline once again. So I'm getting some connection timeout issues, so due to some network, or I'm not sure why it is happening. Generally it doesn't happen. Let me check if it's got triggered. So I will do one thing till it's get deployed. So let's wait let's wait till it's execute the pipeline again. Let me refresh it. Okay, now it start, it already check out the code at 9:24. Current time is 9:24. It now start deploying the code. Hopefully this time there will be no timeout, so please bear with me. Hopefully this time it will deploy the application on CloudHub. Okay, so it has deployed the application successfully to CloudHub this time. Okay, it is updating and now it should generate the reports. So you can see all stages are successful. Let me see the report. So you can see the report here. So nothing is failed. Total request. You can see like all like response time 1040 milliseconds and the response. Okay. So this looks good, everything is green. So previously I have some network issue, so that's why the application failed, you know, doesn't got deployed on CloudHub. Okay, I hope you like this three videos in CI/CD pipeline series. Thanks for watching video.